Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Redmen TV and your latest edition of Transfer Insight. My name is Dan Club. I'm delighted to say I'm joined by the brilliant and the ever smiling Papi Mento from We Talk Ajax. How are we, mate? You okay?
Oh, great, man. Thank you for having me. And I'm actually pretty excited to talk about Gravenberg today. So, yeah, that got me smiling. It's not because of Ajax and how we're doing, but more about the prospect of Gravenberg playing again.
Yeah, absolutely, mate. Yeah, I'm excited about it too. And it's one of them where we've been waiting for this transfer for some time. Now, Liverpool wanted him when he was at Ajax, of course. He obviously makes that move to Bayern Munich, but we'll talk about it in a bit more detail. But yeah, let's get into it. You've obviously seen a lot of Ryan Gravenberg. You came through the famous academy at Ajax. When did you first see him and what were your first impressions of him as a player?
He was actually the youngest to make his debut for Ajax still. And if you think about it, he's only 21. When Frankie de Jong left after our marvelous season in 18-19, he picked up actually the space of Frankie de Jong. He would pick up the ball. He would be the link between attack and defense. And he started playing actually all the matches. And a lot of Ajax fans were disappointed that he left, because the only reason we all thought it was too early, and we thought going to Bayern would put him on the bench, would not give him enough minutes to get enough matches in his feet to get better, you know. And he was still young. If you look now at his age, he's still 21. I mean, he has Europa League experience, Champions League experience, Eredivisie experience. And now with Bayern, I must say, I haven't followed Bayern a lot. I know he's been on the bench a lot, so I don't know the growth in that. But at Ajax, he was already very superb, I mean, on the midfield. Of course, he does have some negatives. All players do. But he's a great player for his age, and I think he can only get better under Klopp.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to touch on that in a minute, sort of what Jurgen Klopp might be able to get out of him. But from his early days at Ajax, I think he made 103 appearances for the first team there. And you mentioned how young he is there. That's a lot of football for somebody so young. And you also said you were surprised he moved to Bayern Munich and you felt like it might have been too soon. Even then, though, could you tell, like, Ajax have lost a lot of their very young, you mentioned Frankie de Jong, they lose a lot of players to different European clubs. Could you tell he was destined for greatness and it was almost inevitable that move somewhere would come eventually?
Yeah, absolutely. The only thing is, do you go to the right club afterwards? I mean, look at examples. We have Donny van de Beek going to United, doesn't play. We have Ziyech that, you know, Tuchel comes, doesn't play. These are all wonderful players for Ajax that leave and then don't get chances in another club. So I think it's crucial for every player that leaves Ajax, be the most dominant player on your team before you leave, because then you get to a certain you have a certain aura about you. When you come to a new team, you have something to say, and you're experienced enough. I think Gravenberg could have led Ajax in the time where we were rebuilding. He could have been our leader. He could have been playing all the games. He could have been the most important player for Ajax rebuilding. And he could have gone to any other club where he would have been playing immediately and not set on the bench like the plan Bayern Munich had for him.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And that's obviously why he's moved on again. He wasn't happy with his lack of football. In terms of his playing style, Papi, you mentioned a moment ago sort of what he offers and what he can bring to the pitch and what he did in his early days at Ajax, of course. I spoke with Ryan Babel on Friday about him a little bit, and he compared him to Paul Pogba. Can you see that? Can you see those comparisons? And if not, how would you describe his style? How would you describe his attributes?
Well, there are similarities in his movement. he plays as an eight. I think Pogba is also an eight role player. I think both of them are very good on the ball. Press resistant, passing is great, ball control, and just not losing the ball. He has a dribble. So I think all those, yeah, it does remind me a little bit of Pogba. Just with Pogba, I don't know his defensive part of the work, you know. Mm-hmm. So I know Gravenberg lacked that a little bit when he was at Ajax. But to be honest, I don't know what he learned in Bayern. I think he just evolved. Even though he wasn't training, he was training with the best in the world. So I'm guessing he must have picked up, better off the ball positioning, off the ball defending, etc. I think that's very important as well to develop for him. But on the ball, his passing, his link-up play, you're going to enjoy that a lot from him.
Yeah, that's it. And yeah, we touched on it off air that he isn't the defensive midfielder that many Liverpool fans were crying out for. We all wanted to go and sign. We were linked with Caicedo, obviously. There was Lavia. There were different players. And a lot of people wanted us to go and get that defensive midfielder. Now, Gravenberch isn't that, is he? He played in a double pivot alongside Edson Alvarez, I think, at times at Ajax. So he has got defensive qualities, but would you say that is definitely the weaker part of his game?
It's not the weaker part of his... Yeah, it is the weaker, sorry. It is the weaker part of his game, but it's also not the his strengths. Like if with Ten Hag, for instance, at Ajax, when Frankie left, what Gravenberch had to do for the team was to drift left and really deep to pick up the ball. And from there, begin the build-up and move to the attack. And he was that player that bridged that gap for attack and defense for us. And that was very important. But also, his dad came with an interview that it hurt Gravenberch's game because he was too far up deep and he couldn't show his attacking prowess, his goal-scoring abilities, his assists, you know, things like that. So I think that's mostly the reason he left Ajax. He wasn't happy with the tactics and how he was being used. But he has a lot of qualities that could help this Liverpool team. I just don't know, because I know you guys also signed a Japanese player.
Yeah, Endo.
Is he also an 8 or a 6?
No, he's a 6. He's a proper 6. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So you could... I think he's going to be backup for Thiago, maybe. Mm-hmm. He's going to be playing in the same spot. And I think his passing was phenomenal. I saw it today. I just went to see some comps of Gravenberch, getting into the excitement, you know. And I saw his passing at Bayern and his dribbling and the way he moves away from players. Mm-hmm. I think that's going to be a real asset for you guys to just get the control on the midfield, you know. And then get the... How do you say, the pace of the game up for Klopp to play his game?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's exciting and you're clearly excited by it as well. What is it that makes you so excited? Is it the fact that one of Ajax's academy players is moving to Liverpool Football Club now? Is it the fact that he's going to work under Jurgen Klopp? And we know he's had a bad year at Bayern Munich. I wanted to ask you, before that, he was very much billed as like your Bellingham type, your Tchouaméni type. He was in that bracket in terms of midfielder, very young, very talented, destined to be one of the best in the world. Is that how you saw it? And can he still go and achieve that?
I don't think he's the best in the world.
Could be, potentially.
I think he's a good player and he will help others play better. And that's what I see of him. He's a really good utility player. I do see some weaknesses. I mean, you know, he doesn't have a great header. I do think he has to work on his off-ball positioning and defending. But on the ball, you're getting a great player. And that's the most important thing, I think, for the club ball to really get some speed in the way you attack from defense to attack, let's say.